ATL. I'm so excited to be sitting here with the director, Mr. Gideon Sarah. How are you?
I'm doing coolly hot.
Yeah, right? This is so cool. You brought so many amazing people out. I love the fact that you turned it into like a futuristic players ball.
Right.
How do you feel about this turnout?
I love it. And my man Porto right there in the doggone hydraulic car, man. Y'all didn't even see that. See, y'all missed out on
that. The hydraulic car. You even had like body paint models up in here.
And we had, what's up, homie? All right.
What?
And then fell back in the seat like fly in the motherfucker.
Outlaw filmmaker, I get it. So tell me what you want people to leave this theater feeling after this movie is done.
Well, you know, I did a player's ball, you know what I'm saying? Not a pimp's ball, but a player's ball, you know. And for the most part, being a player is about feeling good. A player's ball is about feeling good and about looking good. You know what I'm saying? So that's a lot that you can take from a quote-unquote negative source, if you want to call it that. But there's a lot of positivity you can gain from that. You ain't never seen a player walk around with his head down, no matter what he's going through, whether he got cases, whatever. You know what I'm saying? You already see him looking good, smelling good, and walking good. And that's what you can apply to your real life on an everyday basis, whether you're in the game or you're not the game, you know? And shout out to my homeboy, original white folks, man. The original white folks. The person that they took Superfly from and everything, you know? Before the Trick Baby book and all that, the original white folks, man. Hold your head and we rocking for you and representing for you, man.
So check this out. What inspired you to write this movie?
Oh, I'm finna scare you. Y'all ready to be scared? Everything I do, the Most High moved through me to do it. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Even the player style. Even all of that. But that shows that he can relate to our real world. Everybody think that the Most High is escaped from our world or divorced from our world, but he can relate to our world. So everything I do, he moves me to do it. And I don't got no shame about that.
So as he guided you, like, how did he put the pieces together? You know what I'm saying? Like what made you say, I'm going to do a movie about, you know, loosely based on Trick Baby? You know what I'm saying? Like, what? How did that all come about?
Just the atmosphere we was at the time. You know, Bobby Horton kind of kicked off the idea a little bit, you know, and it was just like, you know, he hung around the hood. He's a real street cat, you know, and he was just telling me about his environment, and he reminded me of that character. You understand what I'm saying? A lot of people from different ethnicities try to fit into a certain culture, but he was really being him genuinely, not trying to emulate a culture. And from that, I saw the character Trick Baby, you know? So it's from there, I just took it and explained about the game and explained about something that's missing. The youth don't know about the game and the rules of the game. It's dead, you know? It's like people catching cases and going to jail and got baby mamas and all that other type of stuff. They don't know about the game, you know?
Absolutely. So, I really like the grit. I really like your style. Do you know what I'm saying? How did you decide to put that together? How did you, you know, do the music? Like, how did you just, because it was, you know, what intrigued me is that you use many different styles together. You use a lot of color. You know what I'm saying? You use a lot of different camera work. Like, you really put it down. I was incredibly impressed with the cinematography. So talk to me about that.
Right. I'm an artist. You know, cinematography and camera work, that's artistry. You know, it's just like drawing or sculpting. You know, it's the same type of style. So everybody got their own type of style of how they put together their project, and it's just mine. I can't even decide how it starts, you know, or describe how it starts. Let that brother give you that water real fast.
Oh, we good. This is your interview, honey. Thank you. He's such a player. He always makes sure his ladies are good. I'll teach you. Well, go ahead. I think the movie is about to start, and we're probably being really rude right now, going over my interview. But I already asked you how you want everybody to end. What are you going to be doing in a movie theater? Like, when we enter, are you going to be looking at people's faces? Because, you know, I know you probably watched this movie inside and out, making sure everything is perfect. Like, what are you going to be doing when we go up in there?
I'm going to be chilling and laughing with y'all and kicking it with y'all. I'll be doing these things like kickbacks, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
I am never going to do like a player's ball type of theme again. So these things be like kickbacks. So I'm just going to kick it with the family and hang out and watch the TV, you know? Watch the movie, you know?
Well, I'm so happy you were born. I'm so happy you were born because this is an incredible film. You're an incredible talent and creative. I'm glad you made me a part of it with this red carpet, and I'm super excited. I think you also brought out, I know a lot of these actors that you brought out here, and you pulled out the best of them. Like, they did amazing, and I know they had everything to do with their talent and, of course, your direction. So great job.
Yeah. Let me say this last thing before we end. Shout out to Iceberg Slim, man. Your books have inspired a lot of different people. They gave us a lot of knowledge about a world that a lot of people didn't know of. And your books were designed to help people escape the pains of the streets. So we heard you clear, and I want to make sure your name rings for another generation, brother. Real talk.
That's
thank you, sweetheart, for inviting me out.
Absolutely. Oh, thank you, baby. Gideon Sarah, Sister Cypher, the